Eshu Ilegba walks the hallways of Purdue. He takes my petition to my mothers, who take my prayers to Olodumare, who comes back to Purdue, jumps into my mortal shell, and pushes me to tell each and every one of you that God, yes, God is a woman too. God is the great mother Imaya, who dwells in the oceans and seas, swelling our bellies with the promises of future divinities. God is Mama Oshun, a warrior woman who would die or be killed for what she believes in. Justice, equality, all the while with sword in hand, with sweet honey dripping from her lips to lure the unsuspecting ignorance, to entice the ever-patronizing tones that deem me to be less than and somehow outside of the definition of God. Yes. With her sweetness, she goes in for the kill. God is Miori, Mama Oya, the great force of nature that is the wind. She makes her way to me as the hurricane who destroys ignorance and inequality. Yes, God is a woman just like me. God was a little black girl, her hands dark and as cold, her strength made quiet because of the time she was born into. 1920, in the backwoods of Louisiana, God cleaned homes and nursed the children of white people who were kind and well-intentioned on paved roads to racism. But this was nothing new. It was what her mother and her mother before her knew. Racism smiles at us often while it kills our souls and leaves vestiges of generational trauma. I am the trauma of my black mamas. Excluded from participation to march on this nation. God, oh God, God is a black woman who used her notion of the American dream to achieve her goal of being college educated, having five children with my daddy, both being present to raise them. God taught school to black children who never had the same opportunities, but she loved them to a better understanding of being black by behaving with kindness mixed with a pinch of crazy and a heart and head filled with dignity. God is a black woman. God is the woman who made me. God is the woman who made me. And here I stand, microphone in hand, screaming black to black female deities, do not become so tipsy with the patriarchal powers you have been given that you cannot see the God in me. Do not become so tipsy with the patriarchal powers you have been given that you cannot see the God in me, the God that is me. How dare you or anyone dare deny me, God? I will go alone and stand as 10,000 strong, wrapped in blackness, black history, black culture, black thought, honoring the black women who fought for us to be here today. Yet, my dear lady, my sisters in struggle, I am but one voice, one way of seeing. While my reflection is of Golina Harris and Addie McLean, Helen and Rosie Mosley, James Etta and Ruthie Mae Anderson, I am also Ella Baker, Fannie Lou Hamer, Sojourner Truth, Mary McLeod Bethune. I am the 20 young ladies of the Delta Sigma Theta, the only black women's organization to march in 1913 at the back of the line. But who do you see, my sisters? Who do you see when you look in the mirror of now and the mirror of women's history? I see self-love and dignity. I see a big black woman. You must go forth in your mission strong and find God in yourself and love her fiercely. Love her fiercely.